In this episode, I will discuss episode 2 of the TV show Then Came Bronson, The Old Motorcycle Fiasco. Out of all 26 episodes, this one is probably the one that viewers enjoyed the most because of all the motorcycle scenes. The location was Wilson, Wyoming, near Jackson, Wyoming. It aired September 24, 1969. It was written by Thomas Drake and John Edward Manson and directed by Marvin Chomsky. It had the following guest stars that I'm sure you will recognize: Martine Bartlett and veteran actor Keenan Wynn, who was the son of Ed Wynn. Also, Kerry Lofton, a well-known stuntman in Hollywood who worked on the movie Bullet and Vanishing Point, has a small part as well and may have done some of the stunts in this episode. Also in this episode, Michael Parks sings Tie Me to Your Apron Strings. The storyline has Bronson running out of gas and coasting into a place that happens to sell gas, but instead the owner's wife puts weed killer in Bronson's gas tank by accident.
Motorcycle's coming!
Oh, hey, Briggs. I got an awful crick in my back. You gotta take that shot.
I just filled your machine up with weed killer. We get a lot of calls for weed killer.
Alex, played by Keenan Wynn, offers to help Bronson repair his bike and reveals that he too has a motorcycle. A 1937 Rudge Ulster with a bronze head that is actually owned by Bud Eakins, the action coordinator for the show.
What is it? That's a Rudge Ulster. 1937. Bronze head.
The Rudge Ulster was a British motorcycle manufactured by Rudge Whitworth from 1929 until the outbreak of World War II. The bike had been sitting for 23 years. Alex led his wife to believe that he had sold the bike back in 1946.
How long has it been in mothballs?
Since May 4th, 1946. That's the day I told my wife I sold it.
Alex's wife, Nora, played by Martine Bartlett, hates motorcycles because Alex ran into a car and injured his leg on the day he got back from World War II.
What motorcycle is that? It's yours, isn't it, Alex? And it's the same one, isn't it?
Ma'am, it's my fault that machine is here. It's my fault because it's...
Well, then I'll be glad when you're gone.
Well, I'll leave immediately, if not so.
Now look, Nora.
Now, don't you now look, Nora, me, you liar!
And the old motorcycle fiasco begins. Alex gets inspired to get his old bike running again, and because of the friction with his wife, decides he wants to head down that long lonesome highway with Bronson. Keenan Wynn does some of the riding in this episode himself. Bronson tries to discourage Alex and heads across the countryside with Alex following and trying to keep up. In one scene, you can see Bud Eakins wash out in front of a crowd. At one point, Bronson decides to jump a creek, thinking that Alex won't follow. Bud Eakins uses a Harley-Davidson Sprint 350 built to look like the Bronson bike for the jump. Alex follows and makes the jump too, and is rather pleased with himself.
Thank you.
Eventually, Alex comes to the realization that maybe heading out isn't such a good idea after all, especially at his age. Bronson reassures him, you're only as old as you feel.
You know that old saying, that only as old as you feel? Well, that's true, Alex.
Yeah?
Especially you.
No kidding.
Yeah?
This episode has a sweet ending with Nora wanting to ride again along with Alex.
Well, it was the wrong thing to do.
I've been wrong too, Pop.
Nora, I promise you, I'm never going to ride that machine again.
I'm sorry to hear that. I was hoping maybe you'd give me a ride home.
Well, I hope you liked this episode, and stay tuned for episode 7, where I will discuss episode 3 of the TV show, A Famine Where Abundance Lies. And as Bronson used to say, hang in there.